Welcome to Lit Happens, Saskatchewan's showcase of the literary talent of the province. I am very excited about my guest today, a recent Saskatchewan Book Award winner, Paul Hanley. Paul, welcome to the show.
Thanks so much, Wes.
You're welcome. I am really looking forward to chatting with you about your book, Leaven, which has sort of achieved some very notable recent accolades. So congratulations on that.
Thanks so much.
Now, this isn't the first product of your writing career. This is just something recent in a long list of creative accomplishments. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about yourself, Paul.
Well, I don't know. For some reason, in my teens, I got really interested in environmental issues.
Yeah.
And sort of carried that into writing. And so I've written a lot about environment. And I wrote for the Star Phoenix in Saskatoon for 25 years doing environmental columns. So there's thousands of things I've done. And I've done several books. Back in the 80s, I did a book on ecological agriculture in Saskatchewan called Earth Care. And that did really well. And I think was helpful in starting the organic farming movement here in Saskatchewan, which is one of the biggest movements in North America now. And also done a fair bit of writing on agriculture and environment. And this is kind of bringing together a lot of things I've been thinking about through my whole writing career in this book, Leaven.
Yeah.
And 11 refers to 11 billion people, which is what the UN is projecting the world population will be around 2100, which is probably the peak population somewhere in there. And so that's 50% more people. And we're already overshooting Earth's capacity by about 60%. So what are we going to do to make the world work with that many more people? That's what it's about.
Well, so obviously this is quite a topic to tackle. Something inspired this, something motivated you to do this. Was it just your own personal environmental concerns, or was there some kind of a deeper meaning?
Yeah, I think so. I think, I kind of started to focus around this theme of just doing all this writing on many environmental issues over the years.
Yeah.
And then I felt this is something that's really going to hit us. We're growing the population and also the population of all of our stuff, like all of our livestock, all of our infrastructure, our roads, our cars, everything, all going into the billions and billions numbers.
Yeah.
And what's the impact going to be? And I think it's going to really transform society. In order to deal with this, we have to change everything. Naomi Klein just put out a book called This Changes Everything.
Yeah.
And I think she's really right. And that's kind of where I go with the book, is I think it's going to bring about a complete change of our culture, our agriculture, and even the human race is going to transform itself in order to be able to live together harmoniously with that many people.
Wow. So this is what I'm really curious about now is, what's the reaction been? Because this is some heavy reading for some people.
You know, so there is kind of dealing with this somewhat depressing situation of where we're going with the world. And
yeah.
But then after that, I kind of move into solutions. And I think actually sometimes, you know, when things go wrong in your life or in a society, they're really triggers for transformation. So, when you're in the moment, mm-hmm. it seems terrible, but often they're an opportunity to change and have a better life or a better world than we have now. So yeah. That's the way I look at it. And I was really excited when Jan Martel read my book in manuscript form, and he said, you know, this is a book people should read because it's really about transformation. And so it kind of turns something that's a depressing topic into a hopeful topic.
Right. Yeah, nicely done. Mm-hmm. Now, you recently won in the nonfiction category at the Saskatchewan Book Awards.
Mm-hmm.
Weren't you nominated for others as well?
I was nominated for another one, the Saskatoon Book Award too, which
nice.
Which somebody
went
else
someone
got,
else.
Somebody very deserving, and it's so great. You know, there's so many writers here.
Yes.
So many people are nominated. There's lots of awards, lots of publishers, and if you think of it, Saskatchewan is only about population-wise like a one big city, and yet there's seems to be hundreds of writers and people publishing. It's kind of astounding.
It really is. The creative energy is astounding, and it's often said something's in the water here.
And so many different things, and so many First Nations and Métis writers and publishers too.
Yes,
we're winning awards.
Very talented.
It's great to be among them.
Yeah, nice. So, what's the near future hold for you? Because I can sense that you have a lot of drive.
Yeah, I want to write another book along these lines, and just kind of delving deeper into certain aspects of it, into the kind of ideas of transformation and how that can take place. So.
Nice.
So that's my kind of goal for the next few years. Yeah.
Nice. Well, I know we're running out of time already, but I'd like to get out to viewers where around Saskatchewan can 11 be found.
Well, you know, maybe the easiest way for people is to go to my website, which is 11billionpeople.com.
Oh, that's easy.
And that right on there, it shows you everywhere you can get it. But you can go into, you know, McNally Robinson in Regina. You can go into Chapters. So it's not in a lot of bookstores. Sometimes it's easier just to get it from the publisher online, and there's multiple ways to do it that way too.
Yeah. And do you do the social media thing?
Yep.
Yeah.
So yeah, I'm on Facebook, and it's 11 billion.
Awesome.
Facebook/11billion or however that works. Yeah.
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 Well, I know we're out of time, but I'd like to just extend a big thank you for you to coming up here to the Shaw Studio and just sort of enlightening us.
This My pleasure. Thank you.
Yes. And I know that we're going to have you on again because I can see, I can just see that you have a lot to write about.
Yeah, I do.
Great.
Thank you.
That's all the time we have today for Lit Happens. If you enjoyed today's episode, you can see previous segments on Shaw TV or on my website, westmonk.ca. And you can connect with us online on Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter. So I'll see you next time on Lit Happens.